He's vicious, unrelenting, the pride of Mexico. At 22, the undefeated WBC champion has had a meteoric rise.
Es un orgullo para mí representar ese día a mi país, el día de la independencia, toda la gente mexicana, todo México.
Tonight, with an entire nation behind him, his destiny seems preordained. But in boxing, everything can change in a single punch. Josecito Lopez wasn't supposed to be here.
Lopez stepping up. Oh, they stopped it.
Oh my God, I broke him, man.
Lopez pulls up the upset of the year.
He embodies the essence of boxing. In the ring, anything can happen.
I'm a fan of Canelo, but I still want to go in there and pick his ass. People think he's invincible and he's not.
Tonight, will the superstar's ascent continue? Or will the underdog write another storybook ending? It's Canelo Alvarez versus Josecito Lopez. And nothing is preordained.
All right, fans, here we go. It's time for the bout you've all been waiting for.
Las Vegas on a beautiful September Saturday, where it is also Mexican Independence Day weekend, which has become a huge boxing weekend here in the center of the boxing world. The MGM Grand has been the home to boxing's biggest stars and biggest bouts, and tonight, a new era beckons. Mexican phenom Saul Canelo Alvarez, only 22 years old, but unbeaten in 41 bouts. And some see him becoming the sport's leading star over the next decade. Can he continue his meteoric rise? The next test is tonight, here on Showtime Championship Boxing. We take you inside the MGM Grand Garden Arena. Tonight's theme, Knockout Kings, with a bonus given to the best knockout of the night. In the main event, Canelo Alvarez will defend his WBC belt at 154 pounds. He'll face Josecito Lopez, the man who shocked the boxing world only 3 months ago by knocking out Victor Ortiz and earning his way into tonight's main event. But there is action throughout the night, and Mexico is well represented in each fight. In our co-feature, WBC featherweight champion Johnny Gonzalez defends his title against Mexican countryman Daniel Ponce de Leon. One of the most entertaining fighters of the last few years is back tonight, Marcos Maidana facing the experienced Jesus Soto Caras in a WBA title eliminator. And leading off, it's the first title defense of IBF bantamweight champion Leo Santa Cruz. Santa Cruz won the title in June right here on Showtime, and tonight he'll face a former world champion who had a 3-year reign at flyweight, the now 36-year-old Eric Morrell. And hi, everybody. Good evening. I'm Brian Kenny, and welcome to Showtime Championship Boxing. When Josecito Lopez stepped into the ring against Victor Ortiz 3 months ago, Ortiz Canelo Alvarez had already been announced. Lopez was a last-minute opponent, and everybody looked right past him. Boxing is mapped out kind of like a movie, with stars and bit players. But as it often happens in this sport, the opponent, in this case Lopez, didn't get the script. He broke Ortiz's jaw that night and earned his way into this event. Tonight, he gets another chance to rewrite the movie. But tonight, he will face someone who has proven himself to be a much sturdier leading man. Right now, I'd like to bring in our broadcast team for the night. Mauro Ranallo, Hall of Fame inductee Al Bernstein, and the pride of Brooklyn, USA, welterweight titleist Paulie Malignaggi. Great to be here with all of you guys.
Happy to be here with you, Brian.
Al, let me start with you. 22 years old, very young, already very accomplished. What do you see as possible for Canelo Alvarez as he steps up into superstardom?
He's a unique combination of accomplishment and potential. You know, as you mentioned, 22 years of age, already a pro for over 6 years. He's fought 259 rounds of boxing already. And yet everyone agrees he's still a work in progress. He's going to get better as a fighter. So you can look at it a couple different ways, but one way to look at it is lots of blue sky for Canelo Alvarez.
And Paulie, you look at it, Canelo has fought Hatton, he's fought Cotto, but Matthew Hatton, Jose Cotto, the brothers of the superstars, right? And he's fought a lot of guys who are a little past their prime, but he's still only 22, let's be fair. What do you see as the level of progression? Where is he right now?
Well, I think he's doing just fine. I mean, you're right. He's only fought the brothers of superstars and not superstars. He's fought champions and contenders, but champions and contenders who are past their prime, like Sugar Shane Mosley and Carlos Baldomir. You gotta understand, he's being groomed. This is par for the course for a young phenom being groomed for superstardom. So there's not much criticism there. At just 22 years old, he's barely lost a round. You know, he's doing everything that's asked of him, which is win these fights. The big fights will come. This is just a matter of progression.
Jose Cito Lopez beat Tom Morrow. I said that was my Rocky moment where he beat Victor Ortiz, and it felt like that. Will we see Rocky 2, which, by the way, was one of my favorite Rockies? Yes. Can we see that again?
Well, most boxing pundits believe that Lopez's chances tonight are slim and none, and slim didn't make it to Sin City. However, one cannot discount the size of Lopez's heart, and he believes he is really going to be the first to truly test Canelo by taking the fight to him. He certainly possesses the will, but the champion's size and skill could rob the upset-minded Josecito of his, quote, Adrian, unquote, moment.
And we'll see, Al, maybe in a post-Mayweather Pacquiao world, if this is the guy to lead through the next decade. It's very possible. Guys, thank you so much. We'll let you get ready in broadcast position. Meantime, tonight, you should know, you have to be aware, an added feature here tonight. Athletes, like all humans, react to incentives. And tonight, an added incentive from the promoters of tonight's card. And you, the fan, will be a big part of this. In fact, you will decide who gets paid. If we have two or more knockouts tonight, the fans at home, you fans, and here in the arena, by the way, will vote via text messaging after the main event, and choose the best knockout of the night. The winner of the voting will be crowned Knockout King and be awarded $100,000 on top of his purse, an extra 100 grand. If there's only one knockout, then that fighter will get the $100,000 bonus. Showtime Sports is a leader in integrating social media with our viewers. Here is another way to interact with tonight's telecast.
Showtime Sports brings you the biggest fights. Now get in the game with Showtime Split Decision. Go to sd.sho.com on your iPhone or Android to get started. First, predict the outcome of the fight, then score each round live. Post your predictions to Facebook and follow the conversation on Twitter. Play the game tonight. Undefeated WBC light middleweight champion Canelo Alvarez battles upset-minded Josecito Lopez. Sign up and get ready to score.
We are ready now for live boxing. Mauro Ranallo, take us away.
Thanks a lot, Brian. We are going to get started with our first championship bout of the evening. Leo Santa Cruz won the IBF bantamweight title on Showtime 3 months ago. Now, we'll see if he can successfully defend it for the first time against former champion Eric Morrell. And Morrell at 36, attempting to become the oldest champion in bantamweight history. He is a former WBA flyweight world champion who is 6-2 in world championship fights with two wins by way of knockout.
And you know, it's true, Eric Morrell is not quite the fighter he was 10 years ago, but I'll tell you what, our last memory of Eric Morrell is in a scintillating final round against Abner Mars, in which they went toe-to-toe even in the fight he lost. So believe me, he brings a challenge to Santa Cruz this evening.
And the 24-year-old Leo Santa Cruz indeed making the first defense of the IBF bantamweight title he won back in June here on Showtime with a lopsided unanimous decision win over Vusi Malinga as he maintained a relentless pace outworking his South African opponent in every one of the 12 rounds in Carson, California.
Yeah, Mauro, you're right. This is a kid who loves to get in there and fight. He's all business, not too much razzmatazz, so to speak, but keeps his hands up, comes forward, throws 100 punches around at times. So, you know, it'll be interesting to see how he deals with Morrell's craftiness, because Morrell is probably the biggest name opponent of his career, and so it'll be interesting to see how he reacts to that.
Now let's look at the tail of the tape for this opening contest here on Showtime.
And as we look at this, some of the numbers very similar, but the most salient number is the age. 36 years of age for Eric Morel, as you pointed out, and that's very old for a bantamweight, but he's still an effective fighter. How well will that serve him, though, against Santa Cruz?
We are set now for our first world title bout of the night. Let's get the official introductions from our ring announcer, Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you and welcome to the MGM Grand here in Las Vegas, Nevada, as we have a big night of action coming your way, and it's all brought to you by Golden Boy Promotions and Showtime. We are sponsored by Corona Extra, La Cerveza Más Fina, DeWalt Power Tools and their new 20-volt Max Brushless technology. They are guaranteed tough. AT&T, the nation's largest 4G network. AT&T, rethink possible. And O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices every day. This bout is sanctioned by the IBF. President Daryl Peoples, Supervisor Al Meyer. Introducing to you our three judges scoring from ringside. From Toronto, Ontario, Canada, Alan Davis. From Las Vegas, Nevada, Patricia Morse-Jarman, and also from Las Vegas, C.J. Ross. Introducing to you our third man of the ring, the referee in charge of the action, Vic Draculich. All right, fans, here we go. 12 rounds of boxing for the IBF Bantamweight Championship of the World. Introducing to you first the challenger on my right, fighting out of the red corner, wearing white trunks with red and blue trim, fighting out of Madison, Wisconsin by way of San Juan, Puerto Rico. He weighed in at the bantamweight limit of 118 pounds with a record of 46 wins, 3 losses. He has 23 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the challenger and the longtime former flyweight champion of the world, introducing Little Hands of Steel, Eric Morel. And his opponent across the ring, the defending world champion, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing dark brown trunks, fighting out of Rosemead, California, by way of Huetamo, Michoacan, Mexico. He weighed in at a ready 117 pounds, undefeated in his campaign with a record of 20 wins, no losses, one draw, and 11 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, making the first defense of his title, ladies and gentlemen, here is the undefeated IBF Bantamweight Champion of the World, introducing Leo Terremoto Santa Cruz. And once again, a referee in charge. Now to give instructions, Vic Draculich.
Middle of the ring. You have two seconds? All right. All right, gentlemen, this is for the IBF Bantamweight title. You received your instructions in the dressing room. Again, I want to caution. Knee punch at this point will be called low. Golpes de bajo de este punto ser llamado bajo. That said, I want you to obey my commands, protect yourselves at all times. Obedezca mis comandos y protegerse a su mismo siempre. Touch them up now. Good luck to both of you. Tocalo. Buena suerte.
We are set for the IBF Bantamweight Championship fight. 12 rounds. Here at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, Leo Santa Cruz, the 24-year-old champion, undefeated, making the first defense of his championship against the 36-year-old Eric Morel. Santa Cruz in the brown trunks, the challenger Morel in the white with red and blue.
This is a fight that Eric Morel only fights now, standing right in front of a young man blasting away. In the old days, Eric Morel moved and moved and moved. This is an entertaining Eric Morel. Can he win the fight this way?
Yeah, sometimes when a fighter gets older and becomes more flawed, he also becomes more entertaining.
Morel, a member of the 1996 U.S. Olympic team. 6 medalists, the gold medal won by David Reed. There were 5 bronze medalists, including Antonio Tarver and Floyd Mayweather. And in the early going, Santa Cruz has Morell along the ropes. Morell comes back with a couple of right hands and uppercut up the middle. Minute gone here in the opening round.
Levante, yeah. Levante. Get him up.
Yes, that's fine. I'm sorry. I just couldn't get you.
Overhand right delivered by the champion.
That's a good punch for Santa Cruz. Both men will want to land the uppercuts, and you see Morell trying to do it. And body work, yeah, we're going to see a lot. Wow, this is a fun first round.
And I'll tell you, Morell is making it exciting by standing in there, but by staying in Leo Santa Cruz's wheelhouse, he's going to be forced to fight at a much faster pace than he's accustomed to. It'll be interesting to see as the fight goes on if that wears him down.
Ooh. Wow. Sitting at ringside, you know, these punches are forceful for these bantamweights. They are blasting away.
Yeah, especially those body shots. You can hear them thud.
Minute left in the opening round. It's been an action-packed frame so far as they are going toe-to-toe. Right hand, another lead right delivered by the champion. Uppercut. Morell coming back to the body. Right hand to the body by the champion.
This looks like round 12 of Mara's Morell. It's like a continuation of that.
Morell losing a unanimous decision to Abner Modest for the vacant WBC Super Bantamweight title. Modest will make the first defense of his title against Bantamweight title holder and southpaw Anselmo Moreno November 10th from the Staples Center in Los Angeles here on Showtime. Lead left hook by the champion connects. Morell attacking the body with the left hook. Uppercut from the champion. And really a great opening round fought at close quarters between the undefeated champion, Leo Santa Cruz, and the veteran challenger, Eric Little Hands of Steel, Morell.
Man, that was boxing, wasn't it? And there's the overhand right, which is going to be a very important weapon for him during the course of this bout. And then later on in the round, as Morell continued to stay in front of him, that right hand would land again. Now, this is a round in which both men did very good work, but Santa Cruz, who is accustomed to being right here, was a little bit sharper toward the end of the round as they continued to wail away. Double left hook by Santa Cruz. But Morell using just a little movement there, and he needs to use a little more in this fight if he's going to be effective. They both threw over 100 punches in round one.
Second round underway for the IBF Bantamweight Championship. We're scheduled for 12 or less, and they begin where they left off, throwing punches and bunches, each exchanging the jab. Santa Cruz, known as Terremoto, which is Spanish for earthquake, given to him as a child due to his habit of throwing sundry punches without allowing the other kids to return fire. So far, Morell is attempting to do just that. Another overhand right by the champion, and he has the challenger along the ropes. Morell now clinching momentarily.
Now, Al, you made a good point in round one that overhand right is a great punch for Santa Cruz, and he's really made a habit of landing it through the first round and a half.
Right uppercut by the champion finds its target, another one. We take a look at the show stats in the opening round. Santa Cruz almost doubling the challenger.
And you know, Morell was very active in that round there. Wow, he is ripping on the inside. Morell is standing right where Santa Cruz wants him.
You know, he needs to get out of his wheelhouse, because I'll tell you what's going to happen. He's going to end up being so tired that even if he wants to sit back and box, he's not going to be able to, because he's not going to have the legs due to him being worn down.
11 of Santa Cruz's 20 wins have come by way of knockout, again working that right hand to the body and then the uppercut. One-two combination through the guard.
Morell landed a beautiful uppercut a moment ago, but he's not hurting Santa Cruz with these punches.
Midway through the second round. Again, the champion leading with the left hook to the liver.
which is a signature punch of the Mexican fighters, Paulie.
Well, it is Mexican Independence Day. He's sticking with the culture tonight.
Another overhand right connects by the champion. Morrell staying in the pocket. The fans here in Las Vegas loving the action as the champion again continues to work the body.
Eric Morrell has landed some very good straight right hands. They just haven't backed Santa Cruz up, and I haven't seen anyone back Santa Cruz up yet since we've been watching him.
You know what it is, Al? I think a lot of those body shots are wearing Morrell down, that there's no sting on his own offense when he's coming back and throwing.
And we're only in round two.
Exchanging punches along the rope. Santa Cruz again winding up with the right hand. Misses that one. Right hook to the body by Morrell. Less than 30 seconds left in another action-packed second stanza. Morrell throwing caution to the wind, Al, really continuing from where he left off in the loss against Mattis. And a thunderous roar here in Las Vegas, Mexican Independence Day weekend. Early fireworks here in Las Vegas between Santa Cruz and Morrell.
Another wild round, even though it was one that was dominated by Santa Cruz, it was exciting. But the overhand right, which I have in my keys to victory for Santa Cruz, that I'll talk about as the fight goes on, is a very effective punch. And combination punching as well. Santa Cruz is known for that. That nice, it's a unique combination that Mike Tyson used to always use. Right hand to the body, a right to the head. And the uppercuts have been a staple of Santa Cruz's attack because Morrell has stood in the wheelhouse with him.
We are set for round three, scheduled for 12. Leo Santa Cruz, 20-0-1, the defending IBF bantamweight champion, defending the title for the first time against former WBA flyweight champion Eric Morrell.
You know, Leo Santa Cruz said to us, "I fight so that I won't let the fans down. That's my biggest fear. I don't think fighting this way, he will ever have to worry about that."
No, definitely an entertaining style, that's for sure, Al. Morrell started the round trying to pop a few jabs. Let's see if he has the legs to try to change his mind and start boxing now. It seems like that's what he's trying to do, being that the first two rounds of slugging wasn't that successful.
Now some lateral movement from Eric Morrell. By the way, Santa Cruz landed 54 punches in round two.
He's got to start countering. Morrell is even if Santa Cruz is not landing clean, he's got to start countering. You know, he's waiting for Santa Cruz to stop punching, and then he's punching back. He needs to land some sharp counters so that Santa Cruz can have a little bit of doubt when he's throwing with all that offense.
Morrell looking to extend his career. A father of a 16-year-old girl and a 10-year-old daughter and another child on the way. His first boy is due on December 21st. He and his wife, Francesca, very excited about that. Santa Cruz goes down to the body again, ripping off the left hook. And another left hook to the body, really working on taking away the foundation of Eric Morrell.
Morrell's got to counter that hook to the body with a right uppercut. He's just got to touch him with a right uppercut when he gets hit to the body. He's got to give Santa Cruz doubt about throwing it. He's got to take it on the arm and come with a right uppercut.
Yeah, because right now Santa Cruz just keeps throwing that punch. There's a little movement by Morrell, and he lands the overhand right.
Santa Cruz and his conditioning coach, Daniel Garcia, feeling that they want to throw as many punches in the opening round as they do in the last round. Let's take a look at our show stats, Al, for 12 punches.
You can see so many punches being thrown by Santa Cruz. We're all throwing a lot too, but the accuracy of Santa Cruz at 130, as we see the continuing total there, about half of those are those left hooks to the body.
Yeah, those are doing the most damage for sure, Al.
Final minute of the third round. Morrell gets tagged with a jab. Staying in front of the champion.
Morrell thought his hand speed would be better than Santa Cruz. Not so.
Exchanging combinations. The champion getting the better of it again. Continues to work on the right side of Morrell's body. Landing those crisp left hooks.
A great point you made, Al, about the hand speed. How do you suck the wind out of a speedy guy? You take him out with body shots. The body shots have slowed down Eric Morrell tremendously.
Morrell tries to work the body. but Santa Cruz that much quicker.
Wow.
10 seconds left in the third round. It's been all action here in Las Vegas for the IBF Bantamweight Championship. Santa Cruz and Morrell.
He already cut him. Okay, now you really got to take care of that cut, okay?
Eric Morrell being whacked by yet another right hand on the inside. And you see the fact that that's a three-punch combination there. Santa Cruz never throws just one punch, and that's what makes him so entertaining.
He's winning the fight right now, so you got to step it up. You have to throw more. Throw a little more.
The bell in round four. IBF Bantamweight Championship, undefeated champion, Leo Santa Cruz making the first defense of his title. A proud new papa, as his wife, Marita, gave birth to their first child, Delilah, last Sunday, weighing in at over 8 pounds.
It's a very joyous time for him, and he is fighting like he's going to make this a joyous decision. Eric Morrell just hasn't given any lateral movement to him and has stayed right in the pocket. And that's just playing into Santa Cruz's hands.
Yeah, he came right out this round and got right in the wheelhouse. I mean, at the point now where Morrell may be a little frustrated with not having the legs to box. I remember in the fighter meetings, we were asking Morrell what happened in the Mahrez fight, and he was talking about he didn't have a second game plan once he fell behind. And he said he was going to be more prepared mentally tonight if things didn't work out. Well, he's at the point now where you don't know if boxing is going to be the key anymore. He may not have the legs to be able to move around the ring like he wants to.
You look at the numbers, and you know, it's the power punching of Santa Cruz, as you saw there, he was dominant, and so many of those are body punches.
Lead left hook by the champion, doubles up with the left hook, jab from Morrell, who begins to look like he is slowing down. That investment in the body work in the early portion of this fight really already seems to be paying dividends.
You know, Santa Cruz threw 108 punches in round one of his title fight. He threw 120 in the last round. He just doesn't slow down.
And Morrell not utilizing the footwork, staying right where Santa Cruz can tag him, and he's doing that with the body. And now Morrell valiantly trying to fight back, but not a lot of pop on his punches here in round four with 1:10 left in the stanza. Punch combination culminating with a sweep right uppercut by the champion. And again, they exchange fire here in round four. Less than 1 minute left.
I tell you, Morrell is a tough guy. He's staying in there. And a lot of times, that's what it is with a former champion. All that gets left when they get older is their heart, the champion's heart. And Morrell is just staying in there fighting.
He is taking huge punishment in this fight. Santa Cruz is not a great one-punch knockout artist of any kind, but that kind of, you know, constant punching is going to take its toll.
Santa Cruz continues to work upstairs, goes downstairs to the body, lands another uppercut, shelling up now as Morrell along the ropes. 15 seconds left in the round, and Santa Cruz continues to batter away at Morrell's body. Another good round for the champion here in Las Vegas.
We've talked a lot about the body punching of Santa Cruz. Now that was a double left hook that started with one to the head, which is not, there it is again. He's varying his attack, but I haven't seen a fighter take this many hard left hooks to the body in a long, long time. And on the inside, the uppercut, short right hands, Eric Morrell not able to get off. There's a five-punch combination on the inside by Santa Cruz. Don't make that six. And you know, Eric Morrell just not able to fire back. And we look at yet another sequence from the round, and those left hooks downstairs so strong. Now, you see Morel is certainly not passive. He's throwing punches, but Santa Cruz's defense, better than some people give him credit for, keeps his hands high, hard to hit him.
Yeah, he's a textbook boxer, high hands, high guard. And when you're in his wheelhouse, he moves his hands.
Round five, both have drawn blood in this action-packed encounter for the IBF Bantamweight Championship. Leo Santa Cruz in the brown trunks, the challenger Eric Morel in the white with red and blue. And Morel is now on his bicycle.
Santa Cruz has landed 89 body shots in this fight of the 203 power punches he's thrown.
And now he has Morel along the ropes, lead left hook lands flush. Morel has only been down once in his career against Lorenzo Parra. Here's the unofficial Showtime scoring through four rounds. All three of our experts see it the same. A clean sweep for the champion, Leo Tenemoto Santa Cruz. Now peppering away at Morel. Morel staying inside, but gets again ripped with the right hand to the body and upstairs. And while Morel is trying to come back, there's just no pop behind his punches.
The combination punching of Santa Cruz, just too much for Eric Morel at this point. They worked very hard on strength and conditioning for Santa Cruz, and they felt he could be even in better condition than we saw him in his championship fight, and if anything, that is true.
Santa Cruz started boxing at the age of 8, had close to 90 fights as an amateur, and now undefeated as a professional, making the first title defense here tonight of the IBF 118-pound championship against a former champion, Morel, who continues to absorb all kinds of punishment here in the final minute of round 5.
You know, through 2 minutes of this round, Morel has made an attempt to use his legs, but they're just not underneath him anymore.
And let's not forget, the show is billed as Knockout Kings, with a $100,000 bonus being put up by Golden Boy Promotions to the best knockout of the night. And it'll be, of course, voted by you, the fans.
Santa Cruz, not a power puncher, but he's making his case. He keeps landing these body shots. They're going to take a toll on Morel, and he may get a stoppage late.
Santa Cruz working away on Morel, landing combinations, backing Morel up to the ropes. Morel coming forward. Left hook, right shot to the body. 8 seconds left in the fifth round. It's all Leo Santa Cruz here in Sin City.
That's good. How are you feeling? You're taking too much. You're taking too much. But stop the fight. Stop the fight. Let's stop the fight. Stop the fight. It's enough. You're going to stop it. We're going to stop it.
The corner has stopped the fight. They're waving the fight off. Leo Santa Cruz is successful in his first title defense as Eric Morel's corner asked the referee to stop the fight. So Santa Cruz successful in his first title defense, and he's eligible for the knockout of the night bonus.
Yeah, you know, that was such an appropriate decision in the corner because he was taking monstrous amount of punches, and those body punches were going to take a major toll. And at 36, you don't have to be standing and taking that kind of punishment. Now, as Eric Morel gets, and let's take a look at some of the punishment that he took in that last round. Leo Santa Cruz says this will be his last fight as a bantamweight. Well, if this is his swan song in this division, he went out in style. There's one of those left hooks to the head that hurt Eric Morel. There were many to the body, but obviously, as he kept stalking Eric Morel, and as Paulie pointed out, Morel tried to use his legs but couldn't.
Yeah, exactly, Al. It's a good point. at a certain point, the body shots had just taken too much of a toll. And what happens when you go to the body, the hands drop. Once the hands drop, you open up shots to the head. By the end of the fight, Leo Santa Cruz is landing great body shots and great head shots. I thought it was a great decision by the corner to stop the fight. Morello's a champion. He'll go out on his shield. He wasn't going to quit. The corner made the right decision.
Tremendous heart and courage by Eric Morell. But as we look at this kind of punishment being dealt by young Leo Santa Cruz, it just didn't make any sense to continue. And when you look at Leo Santa Cruz, what a crowd-pleasing style he has. And just that little subtlety of movement shows you he's a real fighter, Paulie.
Exactly. Those are the little nuances. The little nuances. Those are great body shots, great shots, and a little turn to put him in position.
And Leo Santa Cruz reacting to the stoppage. A successful first title defense, a great sign of sportsmanship, and really for Eric Morell, a valiant effort, but the younger, more powerful Santa Cruz just too much tonight. We're set for the official decision. Let's go to Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout has been stopped at the end of round number 5. A referee in charge, Vic Draculich, stops the contest upon suggestion of the corner. He is the winner by way of technical knockout. He is still undefeated and still the IBF Bantamweight Champion of the World, Leo Terremoto Santa Cruz.
Santa Cruz sails to his 21st professional win, retaining the IBF Bantamweight Championship via fifth round TKO over veteran Eric Morell. As we take a look at the show stats.
This is so revealing about this fight because both fighters were active, but Santa Cruz so much more, and landing at 54%. When you landed that in show stats, Paulie, you're doing something.
Absolutely, Al. He lived up to his nickname. They call him Terremoto. It means earthquake, and he was an earthquake tonight.
Yes,
he wouldn't
indeed.
Stop punching.
Let's go back to Brian Kenny.
Fellas, thank you so much. Off to a great start. And, of course, still to come, our main event of the evening, Canelo Alvarez versus Jose Cito Lopez as we celebrate Mexican Independence Day weekend. The celebration, by the way, will continue October 20th when Championship Boxing returns to Brooklyn. The brand-new Barclays Center in Brooklyn will host 3 title fights. And in the main event, tonight's guest commentator back in the ring, Paulie Malignaggi, defending his WBA welterweight belt. Here's a closer look at what's ahead on Showtime Sports.